And I got on that plane on September 3, 1988, and went to the Philippines, and I've been there 20 years. My 5,000 that I had budgeted for 4.5 years started running out at 2.5 years. And as my savings begin to go down, people begin to send me money in the mail.
Praise the Lord.
We like what you're doing. You're doing a great job. Encloses our $25 check, and we hope we can send more in the future. Yeah. I'm debt-free 20 years later.
Whoa!
Amen.
When you obey God, He provides.
Amen.
He guides, He provides, brother.
I went through training in youth with a mission, like a 6-month missionary boot camp, and with about 32 others, and then stayed there. And then I served in that bar girl ministry. I was actually the leader of that ministry. I had a home there. I was single, and I had 17 former prostitutes in my home.
Woo!
With about 8 to 15 other volunteer staff to support what we were doing. We'd preach in a city called Olongapo, 10,000 prostitutes, 30,000 U.S. Navy and Marines, and 450 bars, discos, nightclubs, and casinos. Mm. Sin City, we called it.
Sin City.
Virginia Beach, brother.
10,000 bar girls. We'd preach there all the time, Wednesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and any girls that wanted to leave the bars and follow Jesus could move into our home, and we'd disciple them and help them change their lives. My wife was one of my co-workers, became my wife.
Maybe.
The day I proposed to my wife was the day Mount Pinatubo was erupting. Have you heard of that volcano?
Yeah, yeah,
10 times worse than Mount St. Helens. That's right. I said, "Are you sure you want to marry me? Because God's going to take me all around the world. I'm not kissing anybody till my wedding day, and I'm going to be a virgin on my wedding day. Are you sure you want to marry me?"
Yeah.
And after a long, long, long 3 seconds of thinking about it, she said yes.
Amen.
So I knew I had a hot one. Amen. Because before, I used to think, if I can't get a kiss on the first date, there ain't going to be a second date. But when I gave my life to Jesus, my lips belonged to Jesus from that point on. Amen. Amen. That's the way it should be, right?
Well.
So I got married in the Salvation Army because it was one of the only churches that survived that volcano. 45 other churches were demolished, including our home. So the only one that survived was William Booth's chapel. Amen. And William Booth, or General Booth, or, well, I've always been great heroes of mine. So I named my first daughter Evangeline, which was the daughter of William Booth, also the daughter of Jed Smock, evangelist in Missouri, whom I had been following indirectly through his tapes and his books while still a Marine, being discipled by another evangelist who was in the Navy at that time named Stephen White. Stephen White was an evangelist in the Navy who discipled about 8 or 10 of us during a 3-year period in the military. He got out and moved to Pennsylvania, and then I got out and joined YWAM. So that's how I began to indirectly get involved from a distance with you types of guys, you types of people, reading your material, watching you on the internet,
there
getting books, etc. Gillis, I had been following for almost, 18 years now, but hadn't met him until just 2 days ago.
Wow.
And so for Jed Smock, another example, I'd been, you know, reading, following indirectly from a distance, but never got to meet him until 10 years later, you see. And so I have no reason to not believe there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of preachers around the world that are likewise.
Mm-hmm.
They're connected to us indirectly from a distance. We haven't met them yet.
We haven't
met them.
Come on, bro.
And there's a whole movement of preachers throughout the nations doing what we're doing,
right.
But we just haven't met them yet.
See that?
We haven't met them yet.
Right.
So always be encouraged knowing that we are not alone on the front line.
Amen, yeah. Brother.
Of course, my daughters are named Evangeline and Victoria. So my wife's name is Liberty. Great name, huh?
Yeah.
And my first daughter's name is Evangeline, like Evangeline.
Sweet.
Great name. And Liberty, like Liberty in Christ. I often joke, if I have a boy, maybe I'll name him Bjorn again. Hi, I'm Bjorn again. What's your name? One of my responsibilities in Youth with a Mission is helping lead a training center in Manila. Manila is my hometown, 16 million people.
Wow.
Amazing, huh? More than Manhattan. 16 million. It's so busy there you can't drive every day. Depending on your license plate number determines what day of the week you can't drive. Because if everybody drives anytime they want, total traffic jam. And so this is the training center. There's 32 of us. on the training center, and I'm one of four leaders of this center involved in training missionaries to go into all the world. The school that I personally direct is a school of evangelism. It's a six-month school, 3 months classroom lecture stay in, and 3 months application or outreach. Philippines, China, Philippines, Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, or Thailand is where we always go. This is the streets of Manila. Okay. 200 days a year in the streets. This is in front of a raunchy, nasty movie theater in Manila where they caught almost 32 gay couples that were using this theater as a meeting place.
No.
They raided it, arrested all of them, and closed the movie theater. Praise just a few years. It's been closed for many years already.
Praise yeah. Lord. Jesus. Yeah.
So we're seeing a great move of righteousness in the Philippines. Amen. I just finished last year walking 745 miles with a 12-foot cross, 43-pound, like Arthur Blessed type cross,
yes.
And preaching in 80 towns in 59 days. It's all over the internet. I won't show you now. But next year, this will be what I'll be doing with my students. We'll be walking 400 miles, a shorter trip, covering 50 towns of the island of Samar. The island of Samar is just one of 7,000 islands in the Philippines. So that'll be next May to July. So while you're here, think about us, walking with this cross, preaching to everything that moves.
Come on, brother! Yeah.
Amen, brother.
Oh, another one of my responsibilities, and I'm the director of what's called Suge. Suge is an outdoor jungle survival leadership training course for missionaries.
Ooh.
And so I take missionaries into the jungle 6 times a year, limited clothes, limited food, and limited sleep. You see, training them how to, handle the roughness of missionary life. And so I was able to apply my Marine background in that. It's like a mixture of Survivor, Fear Factor, Amazing Race, and Marine Corps boot camp.
Sign me up, bro!
Yeah. 6 times a year.
He's a real Marine,
and every 3 years we return to America for 6 months, just like now, traveling across the country, preaching where we can on campuses. This is an average route every time we come, 30,000 miles, 30 to 40 states, and any other unusual place. So I shared that so that we can have basically for relationship's sake, since we'll all be working together in the future. And relationship definitely is what binds us together and needs to keep us together, whether we're here or afar. We're bound together, and we're on the same team. I hope you can say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.